Macie w Niemczech najlepszy program leczenia SM. Proszę powiedzieć właśnie, jak wygląda opieka nad chorymi?
Well, we have first of all many neurologists with a special interest and expertise in multiple sclerosis, both in MS centers attached to hospitals, but also in private practice. They have close contacts to radiologists with MRI diagnostic facilities. We have nurses and ancillary health professionals that allow, and social workers that allow to sort of comprehensively assess the patient, counsel the patient, monitor, initiate treatments, monitor treatments. So that allows the early diagnosis, the early initiation of therapy, and a continued monitoring of the therapy. Plus, which is very important, making sure that all the societal, social, occupational consequences of the disease are also being dealt with.
Można powiedzieć, że stawiacie na kompleksową opiekę, czy również na terapię indywidualną, spersonalizowaną.
Right. I mean, this obviously is the overall theme across medicine, that you tailor therapy to each patient. Unfortunately, in many cases, we do not have very clear-cut indicators, for example, therapy. Therapeutic response markers or prognostic markers. However, what we know, we sort of condense and apply to the individual patient and then try to make an educated choice about the specific treatments. You know, personalized or precision medicine goes further and looks for biomarkers like or genetic signatures that would identify a very specific subtype of the disease that a patient is suffering from, that would allow a very specific high precision targeting of that particular disease subtype. The implication being that then the therapy would be more effective.
Nie macie problemu z nowoczesnymi lekami, no, z dostępnością do nowoczesnych leków. No właśnie, co dają te nowoczesne leki? Czy dzięki temu macie mniej osób niepełnosprawnych?
Well, I mean, this is very difficult to provide clear-cut evidence, scientific evidence. I should also qualify, while we have more or access to all the approved drugs, the health economic limitations of the system are also now coming into play. For example, previously, if a drug was approved, a company could ask any price for the drug. Now, the regulation is such that after 1 year, the company has to provide evidence that this new drug is either more effective or does offer additional benefit, and that health economically it makes sense to you know, pay the additional amount of money for it. So I would qualify this. The 20-year experience with the beta interferons or glatiramer acetate have produced a lengthening of the interval of patients to develop the secondary progressive form, and that basically means that there is a slowing of disability accumulation. I'm sure that, so it's very difficult to prove scientifically, but I think the collective experience would suggest that.